Hey, horsey and gun people. Crap. I did a video of this, and evidently I took a picture instead of doing a video, so I was out there yapping, thinking I was recording. And then when I uploaded it, it was just a picture. So I had this little medicine cabinet that I had sitting out in my horse shed, and it was getting really rusty. And this is one side here, and I sprayed some rust converter on this, and I showed the can. I'll slide in a picture. But I've sprayed some rust converter just on this part and not on this part. And you can tell that spray on really kind of stopped the rusting and did a pretty good job. It left a black flat paint. And I wanted to upgrade this and do it a little bit better. And because the medicine cabinet was kind of on the wall and I didn't take it down, this is what the top looked like that I didn't spray with the rust converter. And you can tell it's peeling and looking pretty bad on the inside and everything. So I end up putting some rust converter on it. So instead of using the can spray on, I used this corrosive seal. It's water-based. You can rinse it. It's easy cleanup. And basically, you just paint it on. And like I said, I did a video and showed all the things I was doing, but it didn't come out. And so now I'll get to the video that did come out. But this is what I end up using on it. Hey, horsey and gun people. I had this little medicine cabinet out here for my horsey medical stuff. And it was really getting rusted and kind of just caking up. So I've been using this rust converter on a lot of things. So you see this kind of like rust, this I'm just knocking it down with this wire brush. That's the only prep I'm doing. Over here it's not too bad. I don't think I need to knock this off. Top's pretty bad. Or this is the bottom, rather. You can tell it's pretty rusted. So, I am just knocking off a little top rust. Dump all that out. There's some. Oh, yeah, it's really. Now, because this rust converter. And I'm putting some stuff in here. That's probably a little corrosive. So I'm gonna dump all this off. Now, I didn't even scrape this before. I just sprayed that rust converter on it and it put a nice black anti-rust sheet on it. So I'm gonna just paint this whole thing because it was hanging up on the wall and I just kind of sprayed what I could get used to. You can tell the difference from where I sprayed the bottom and where I didn't spray the top. So I'm just gonna dump all this rust out. I probably should hose it off and let it dry, but maybe I'll do that. It's hot enough today. It'll dry pretty quick. So I'll hose it off, rinse off all the stuff I just scraped, and then I'm going to spray this rust converter on it. You know what? Maybe I won't spray it because this isn't enough. I don't have enough. I thought I had another bottle. I'll have to check to see if I have another bottle. If I don't have another bottle, I'm going to use this stuff that I used over here on this piece of metal. And you'll see the difference between the stuff that you kind of paint on and the stuff that you, the boys are all back there with their little friends. Some new horses showed up in the back corner, so that's like their new hangout. They all herd up there, even though they're in the sun. I wish that was a big shaded area, because then they could all hang out there in the shade. So, this piece right here was rusting really bad. And it was looking like this, but a lot worse. So I did not treat the two sides with anything. And it's still kind of rusting out here because it had a coat of paint on it and it sit outside. Now this side, the black part, I sprayed with that can. That's all I did.
and I sprayed the can down there too. But then I got out this liquid stuff that I had, and I actually just kind of painted it on there. You can see I wrote Mr. T. I don't know if you guys can see that. It says Mr. There's the R, and then there's the T. So I don't know if that's coming out on camera. But anyway, this is where Mr. T died, for those that keep up my horse channel. What the hell is that underneath? Oh, that's a feather. I was like, damn, that looks like a leg. It's a feather. feather, not dot. Anyway, so I painted this with this rust converter thing, and it made like a protective clear coating. You can tell it turns black, it says, where it hits rust. So when you paint this rust converter on, it turns black wherever it finds rust, and it sticks to your hand. It's really hard to come off. I would recommend wearing gloves. Because, I mean, I really had to scrub to get that shit off my hands because I didn't put hands on it. So you can tell where it's rusted, it kind of turned black. It didn't turn black where I put this black coat on here. So this is where I had a little bit of that rust converter spray, and I just sprayed. So I intentionally did not paint over this area to see if this starts rusting first or if this rusts first. They're both rust converters. They both change rust into something. The black spray paint obviously goes on black. The other one goes on clear, and it turns black, all those black specks, when it hits rust. So this front looked like this before I put anything on it. And the top looked like that because it was holding water. And I just painted it. So I'm going to end up doing that to that little medicine cabinet. I'm going to go ahead and paint this stuff on it because I don't have any more of the spray stuff. And I'll show you the bottle of that stuff. I also sprayed with that spray stuff. My chains on my horse trailer were kind of rusting and stuff. So I just laid them down, as you saw right there, and I gave them a good coat of that rust converter to stop the rusting. I also got under the horse trailer and sprayed my frame with the spray can. So here's what the jar that I'm using inside looks like. Let me interrupt Moki because he's in there sleeping like, dude. Where's that crazy cat? He was sleeping right there. I don't know where he went. So this is the rust converter that I used on that brown thing out there that I painted on. Rust converting metal primer. So I'm going to go ahead and pour some of this in a jar. You don't want to dip or make any oxygen or anything get in here. So always pour it out and use a little, but I'm gonna go ahead and do that. These are all my little gifts that I got. I was gonna do this. I think Susan sent me all this. It's a great package. She's bugging Buck though, so I haven't answered her. I'm kind of proud to be an American. She gave me all this great stuff, and then this came in. I mean, I got so many things that, but I need to get this project done. I gotta hang that up too. My little air hose thing that spins up. That's really handy. I've got that thing there that is 50 feet, so I can pull it out anywhere outside or inside, and it keeps my extension cord out of the way. So I always have an extension cord that can wind up. That was really worth. This was on sale on Amazon during the Prime Days for like 80 bucks, and it's normally 159. And I was like, man, I don't need that, but shit, for 80 bucks. I mean, hell, if I went out and bought a new hose that was 50 feet long, it'd probably cost me that much. This comes with a nice, you know, it locks and everything. So now I got to figure out how to mount it. I'm trying to get this piece of wood because mounting on the steel, it's too wide and the holes don't hit the steel. So I got to mount a piece of wood on this steel and then mount that to the wood. But that's my other project. So anyway, we'll see how that goes. So I'll make another part when I get this thing painted. Oh, there comes a little Ransom. Hi, Ransom. Did you lose Buddy? See, I can tell you just lost Buddy. You can tell by the look on his face. He's like, shit, where'd Buddy go? Oh, he's over there getting a drink. So he saw Buddy, so he'll go around. Let's see how they cross paths. If they, Ransom will give way to Buddy. So Ransom stopped. I don't know if Buddy stopped too. I gotta do on my horse channel. It looks like Ransom might have had a little abscess on his foot, and that may be why he's limping worse, or appears to be worse. I'm not sure where Buddy stopped. He probably stopped in that shade tree over there. And Rance was like, I'll just wait, go get a drink later. I don't want to deal with that crazy monster horse. There's Buddy. What are you doing, boy? What are you doing? So I gave him some hay this morning around Mr. T's gravesite. And that stone, a lot of people have asked what happened to the gravestone for Mr. T. It's on order, but they said it takes 6 to 8 weeks. So when I get it, oh, look at all the horses in the back there still at the watering hole. So Bell, the other three horses and a donkey are all back there. So Buddy and them, I guess, decided to come get a drink. Come up here and snack. Anyway, this is about freaking my project. Let me get off on my horses. All right, we'll see how this thing looks. Okay, it's about an hour later. Hi, Buddy. Why didn't you sneak up on Dad? You gonna drink water, boy? All right, so saw me scrape off that stuff. I rinsed it. I let it dry. I wiped it down with paper towel, let it set in the sun, dry a little bit. And then I put a coat of this rust converter on it. Just use a little brush, a little plastic container I had. Plastic seems to do well for rinsing and it doesn't stick, but it sticks to metal. Remember that pro tip I gave you about wear gloves? Because that black stuff will not come off. What happens is I've rubbed my hands on a little bit of rust, and then when that converter hits it, it turns it black. So you can tell it almost turns it a purple looking color when you paint it. And then it bonds and dries. So over here, you can tell at the bottom, I painted it with that black stuff first, and at the top, I just put the thing. And on the back, I didn't use any black. All I use is clear, but all the black you see is a little bit of rust. It almost looks like it's still rusting through right there. But I know I covered it good. And then this side, I didn't put any of the spray-on rust converter. I just used the brush on. And you can tell the black dots and how it turns black when it seals. So I let that dry. I think it's supposed to dry for like 24 or 36 hours. I'm gonna get a can of spray paint, white spray paint, and paint over that. And hopefully all the rust will stop. We'll see how it looks at the end. Okay, so put one can of white spray paint, high gloss on the outside. I did one coat on the bat, let it dry. I ran out of can. Had to go get another can because I thought one can was going to do it, but it looks like it's going to take more than one can. So I used about a half a can to go ahead and finish and touch up because some of the black was coming through. And so that's what it looks like after I'm done here. Got the bottom and the back and everything done. Hopefully it's rust-proofed. Sitting outside in that little shed. I'll put the mirrors back on it, and I'll show you a final when the mirrors are on it. And here's the final product. Turned out pretty good. I mean, it's still got the rust spots here and there, but otherwise, the door's closed. Shelves are good. I'm thinking about putting a little mat here because when I put all these things in here, sometimes if they leak or something, it tends to eat away at the paint or acidic. So I might, sorry, dropped my phone, turned it off. I might put some rubber mats in there. But that's the final product of the little, what do you call it? Medicine cabinet project. So that's final product of the medicine cabinet product. I just got to put all my stuff back in there and figure out how I'm going to put those little things in there. But hopefully that will stop the rust. All right, we'll end that there.